Hey everyone. Hi guys. I can't hear you guys. Come on. Hi guys. Much better. So, how does it feel to see a girl racer? I know it's pretty weird. It's new that, you know, we usually don't see girls racing out there. But first of all, thank you so much TEDxBITSHyderabad for having me here. Hyderabad is quite special because when I was coming today morning from the airport, I actually saw the first ever racetrack I ever drove on. That was at the Hyderabad airport, the track over there. I was very emotional. So thank you so much for getting me back at Hyderabad. So yeah, I want to take you all through a series, just like how it feels to be a racer before the race and like when we are racing, before I start my talk, like, you know, share my story. So first of all, we stretch it out before our races. I was stretching out there, yeah, so that I'm prepared, I'm flexible before my race. So we have this, you know, a cycle of thoughts, not all the times, but sometimes when we are stressed out, we have like so many cycle of thoughts, whether, you know, how is it the race gonna be, what are we gonna do, how are we gonna overtake, who's gonna overtake us, you know, what if we don't win, or what if, you know, something happens to the car. But thank God it doesn't usually happen to us all the time, but when it happens, it's a very, you know, difficult moment for us as racers. It's very, you know, we get scared at times, but that's racing. We have to live with the risk. So let's just all imagine that we have put on our suits. That's like, just imagine this is my suit. But let me tell you, it's very hot inside when we are actually in this, wearing the suits. They are quite thick. And then we put on the helmet. And at such a moment when we are very stressed out during our races, the one thing which always calms us down is getting inside the car and just relaxing and just forgetting the, you know, stress and just forgetting the expectations people have from us. I usually do that. I just go to sleep wearing my helmet in the car. So yeah, that's how. And then I see my mechanic strapping me down with the seat belts right before the race, you know. That's when I know this is it. That's the time I'm supposed to forget everything and just go out there and do something I love. So when we get on the track, when we start on the engine, we forget everything. It's like, you know, we feel that we are at home. Even when we are at the racetrack, it doesn't feel that you are at home. But when you hear the engine roar, it's perfect. Things, you know, looks under your control and you feel at home. It feels great to be a racer doing what we love. So, yeah. And then once we start, we see the green lights come on. You know, all your strategies and what all you have planned that, okay, I'm gonna, you know, go over here and overtake the guy in front of me. Whatever strategy it is, you forget everything. The fun racer in you comes ahead and takes over. And it's like, you know, forget you adjust into your zone, driving the cars at the speed of 230 kilometers per hour, and you don't even feel it. You feel it's so slow. Why are we not going so much, you know, like even more faster? And we enjoy it. We race together. I race with the best champions in India. There are the 12 boys, and I have been racing with them since 2 years in the Formula BMW cars, and it's fun for me. So the G-forces and, you know, like the air, the wind that affects us, there is just one disadvantage which I have got as a girl. The lucky boys, they don't have this hair, you know. It's like the struggle. You sweat so much in the car because, you know, the G-forces are so hard, even if it's like an open place and even if it's a cool atmosphere, it gets very difficult to handle this hair. But luckily, I don't see myself as a girl racer and I see myself as a racer. So yeah, you know, it feels good to be, as you know, inside the car. So now let me tell you my story. When I was 8, my father started a go-karting track in Vadodara, a very small racetrack. I would just drive there for fun, but this is where the two parts which I'm going to be talking about through the session talk is dreams and choices which we make. my father had a dream that, you know, he loved cars and bikes, so he wanted to be a part of motorsports. Somehow, at his time, he couldn't do it. So he started this go-karting track. He took a decision for himself and for his dreams that, you know, I should be doing something alongside my business, and that was the go-karting track. And the blood flows, you know, the same blood. So there was this passion in me, and I hope he's living the dreams in me. When I first sat in the go-kart, I directly went and hit the wall. I was just 8 years old, and it's pretty funny. I was so scared when I hit the wall, and I hit the steering wheel in my stomach. I didn't drive for a month. I was scared. I was asking myself, should I really do it? You know, I know I love cars. I know I love speed, but this is scary. You know, I shouldn't be doing it. But this is where I took my first ever decision and made a choice for myself, unknowingly, just 8 years old. I didn't know that I was making choices for myself. So I took a choice of, you know, getting back into the go-kart with someone sitting beside me for some time. But I got back into the go-kart, and I started working out on my fears. I started making sure that I go fast, and I remove my fears. I face my fears, and that was my first ever choice, which I did to make, you know, possible to live my dreams and do something which I love. I didn't know that, okay? And when I turned 9, my father asked me if I wanted to start, you know, professional racing, and I didn't know anything about it. I was just 9. Obviously, if a father asks a girl if she wants to drive cars and if she has a passion for it, she wouldn't say no. And that was me. I went ahead, and that's when I saw that there are no girls, you know. It's just the boys. And I asked him if I'm supposed to race with them or there's a different group for girls. And he said, no, come on. Go ahead, race with them. So I was like, yeah, right, you know. I took this decision of getting back into the go-kart because I saw my brothers having fun. And I was jealous that why should boys have all the fun? So I took the decision and I got back. And now I'm here, you know, getting trained as a professional racer. And in just 5 days, I was here in Hyderabad driving my first ever professional race. It hasn't been easy for me. It was quite difficult, you know. The male ego obviously wouldn't let a girl come ahead of them, but, you know, this girl, she just wanted to go out there and have fun. And I wasn't, you know, I got so many questions saying, how did you know that, you know, at such an early age, you took racing as your profession? I didn't take it as a profession. I was just there doing something I love. And I want to tell you all that do something that you love and not think about your future that moment. Just stay in the present, love, and do what you love. So yeah, I got better at it. First 2 years, I was okay. I was just having fun, not that serious. But there was another decision which I took for myself, choice that I did when I was 12 years old. And that was again in Hyderabad. I don't know why. So there was this race in which I was supposed to start last. And that's when I told myself, Mira, this is it. You got to win this race. No matter what, give it your everything you have learned. And if you don't win, forget everything else. You're not doing it. And I made sure that in the next 3 laps, I was leading the race. And when I came out, you know, the faces which the people had and the faces the competitors had and the shock they had that, you know, oh my God, look at her. A girl just won the race after starting last. And that's when I decided that this is my passion. This is where I belong. And I'm going to continue doing this. I'm going to be on the racetrack racing with the boys my whole life. And I'm going to do something I love. And I keep doing it. Obviously, there are not, you know, we don't get success so easily, and I didn't as well, and I'm not still successful. I'm just a learning. I'm just a person who's learning. When I was 14, I didn't do quite well in my go-kart races, but luckily, I made it to the Indian Formula cars, and the most experienced person over there was 35 years age, and I was racing with all the most experienced racers of India, and I was just 14. I didn't know how to drive a car, And I started from zero. So that's where this another part comes, where you got to decide that you're going to learn from everything you know, every person you meet, from everything you go through. And I started from zero. It was very difficult. When you are winning the races in go-karts and when you are zero in Formula cars, it's very bad, you know, for yourself. You start pushing yourself so much. And it's a good thing for me. It helped me out. I started pushing myself out of my comfort zone for something that I love doing. And I did pretty well. First year, I didn't get the results. Second year, I didn't get the results. Third year, I finally, with a lot of hard work, a lot of practice on the racetracks, driving cars, I finally got my third fastest. I was the third fastest, person, like the racer on the track. And I felt this is it again. You know, I again find a reason to be on the racetrack and race cars, just like I did when I won the race. So I worked hard, and luckily, in 2016, I won the National Rookie Championship and became India's first girl to do that. And I'm proud of it because, thank you. I'm proud of it that I did it because, you know, dreams do come true, but only if you work hard. And after that, going back to when I started racing, I was in Malaysia in 2010 and I saw this, Formula cars, Formula BMW cars, and I saw that, you know, just like a little girl, I dreamt that this is going to be my next step and I'm going to soon drive these cars. And in just within a few years, I made sure I did that and I became India's first girl to drive the Formula BMW cars where all the champions race together in India. Thank you. And it's a great feeling, you know, but it didn't, you know, it was just not a happy moment for me because I struggled with the cars, starting from zero again. I didn't know what to do. And I gave my everything, but I had car issues. Everything comes. We have to face it. We have to take the challenge and walk through it. The first race, I didn't do well. I was okay. The second race, I didn't do well. I was still okay, but started feeling a little low. But I told myself, you know what, just learn through it, stay strong, and you're going to make it through. You learn everything. You learn from the situations, how to handle yourself, how to handle your mental fitness, how to stay positive about everything, how to learn your racing skills, how to improve them. And I did it, you know. In 2018, I came back much more stronger, and yes. So in 2018, the 12 drivers were just racing within 1 second. It has never happened ever before in racing. And I'm proud that I actually did it. And I was with the boys, racing them with them, giving them a tough competition. And it all came through, you know, ups and downs, working hard through it, and being depressed at times, but, you know, making sure that I pull myself up because this is what I do. This is what I love doing. And I don't want anything else to come in my way and stop me from doing something that I love, because it gives me real happiness. And, you know, that's what I want to tell you all. You know, we have a great life. Of course, it's short, but don't let anyone take decisions for yourself. Don't let anyone decide what is your happiness. We are here to do what we love, and we are here with a purpose. Why let anyone else, you know, come in our way of our purpose and ourselves? It's all about finding it. It's all about working hard through it. It's all about enjoying every day and every moment. And it's about learning from every person we meet and everything that we go through. And I have done that. I'm learning it again. I'm still learning. I'm still going through, you know, ups and downs. But I have learned and I have made sure that I keep doing that. So always make sure that you enjoy your life. I'm doing mine and I'm going to keep doing that. And I'm going to face the challenges as they come. But let's just have fun. Let's support each other. I support my competitors. They support me. And we make a great team as racers because they don't see me as a female racer because I don't see myself as a female racer. And I see myself as a racer because the car doesn't know what gender is driving the car. It's about, you know, being dedicated to something and being, you know, going out of your comfort zone every time you drive it and learning through it. So I feel that's what I want to tell you all, and I hope I have, you know, given you enough reasons to know and enough examples to follow your dreams and to live every moment of your life. And I feel, I hope to see you all standing here soon at my place, and I want to be the one standing, you know, sitting over there and listening to you all, to your success stories. So just be happy and keep supporting each other, keep pulling each other up, and we'll make a world, our world, a better place to stay. Thank you.